Hello! In this episode of Bug Bounty Reports Explained, I have a $29,000 arbitrary file read vulnerability in GitLab. The bug had to do with Symlinks, and I'm quite surprised we don't see this trick used more often. Anyway, the report was submitted by William Bowling, whose reports I regularly cover on my channel because they are really, really good. So is this one, so without further ado, enjoy my explanation. On GitLab, we can create groups and milestones within them, which isn't that important, but important is the fact that we can also upload files as attachments to these descriptions. And GitLab can work as GitLab.com, the global instance, but it can also work as self-hosted one, which you install in, for example, your own company. And if you create a group in one instance, and then you want to move everything into another one, GitLab allows you to do this by simply importing the URL of the GitLab instance and also the access token. GitLab can then go and fetch all the information about your original group and import it to another instance. For this particular report, the setup that William created looks like this, that from GitLab.com, you import a group which actually imports itself also from GitLab.com. The reason is that we don't care about importing most of the things. There is only one file that we will have to change, and our proxy server changes one single response and the rest of requests go simply back to GitLab.com, but GitLab.com does not know about it. Let's talk about symlinks. Symlinks, or symbolic links, are files that refer to other files on the file system. There are two types of them, and we are talking about soft links, which don't actually store the file's data, but they refer to the actual file's location. You can think of it as a shortcut. And this is the command that I would use to create a symbolic link to my /etc/passwd file, and the symbolic link itself is called symlink. If I do anything on this file, the system will work as if I was working on /etc/passwd file. The attack scenario we could try is to upload a file, a symlink, to the server, referring the /etc/passwd on the server, hoping that the server will resolve the symlink and give us the /etc/passwd file or any other file from the server. But the problem with this approach is that the browser, when we do this, will just upload our own /etc/passwd file to the server. In fact, when I first learned about this vulnerability, that's exactly what I've done. I uploaded my own file from the server, and I thought for a second that I found arbitrary file read. The problem with this approach is that the information about the fact that it's a symlink and not the file is not in its contents, but in information about the file. And whenever you have a file upload functionality, you usually only upload file contents and not, for example, permissions or information that it's a symlink. Normally, this attack won't work unless you have a functionality that doesn't work on a single file, but works on archives like zip or tar. In this case, when importing all the data about the group from one GitLab instance to another, our attachments were packed into a tar archive and then unpacked on the new server. What GitLab should do to be secure is it should remove the symlinks on every single unpacked file, but in this case, it didn't. This is how you could exploit this on GitLab.com. First, you create a new group and a new milestone. In its description, you upload an arbitrary file, doesn't really matter what are the contents. It's uploaded to a folder with a random name, which you have to copy. And then, locally, you create the directory with the same name, and inside, you use this command to create a symlink. The first argument is the file that you want to steal from the server, and it can be an arbitrary name. Then you create an archive with this file. Now you create a proxy server that will forward all requests back to GitLab.com so it can fetch all the data about the group that you are trying to import. You only modify a single response, the one with the uploads.tar.gz file, and instead of requesting this one from an actual GitLab instance, you return the tar file that you've just created. The vulnerable GitLab instance will then unpack this file without removing symlinks, and all of a sudden, if you try to open the uploaded file, you will see the etc/passwd file or whatever else you tried to steal. After some arguments about the risk, and in particular about the integrity impact of this bug, it was classified as critical and the payout was $29,000. The bug was fixed in GitLab 14.6.2. If you want to see other reports by William, check out this GitLab playlist. There is his 20k RCE in image metadata, but also his XSS that he escalated into an arbitrary file read. XSS into arbitrary file read, a fantastic report. The playlist is on your screen right now. For now, thank you for watching and goodbye.